Hello and welcome. You're watching our YouTube segment this morning coming in from the gates of the Jawaharlal Nehru University. Now, what happened yesterday has sent shockwaves across the country. People can't believe that the visuals that were seen yesterday came from inside a campus. There were about 50 goons, masks on, and sharp weapons, sticks, some sticks with a stone pasted on top, wrapped up and tied up on the top, used, and they went in from one hostel to the other on a total rampage. The result of it was that 40 faculty and students combined landed up in the hospital. It all started at 6:30 last evening, and we only know that it's after 3 hours. At 9:30 p.m. is when finally the flag march of Delhi police was carried out. These gates that you see right here behind me are now open, and currently anybody who has an ID card is being allowed to go inside. But yesterday they were locked. There was a chain around it, and there were protests happening outside on the street right here, and there was violence inside. Here, these street lights also that you see, they were shut down, and students telling us that nobody was allowed to come in. It all started, and it's important to understand the difference. This is not an anti-CAA protest, as many have been talking about, by the way. This started as JNU has fought a 70-day battle against fee hike. Today was supposed to be the first day of the new semester, and in the weekend, from Friday, Saturday, Sunday, registrations are supposed to begin. These registrations and this semester was boycotted by the student body. They believe that had registrations taken place, it would have legitimized the new fee. Thus, there was a tussle and a going on between the ABVP and the left wing, between the JNU administration and ABVP on one side and the left parties on the other, towards whether or not registrations will begin. Now, as a fallout of that, we understand that there were some incidents and episodes of scuffle, etc., that took place on Friday and Saturday. And it's on Sunday evening when things really got out of hand. We are told around 4 o'clock a meeting was called between the faculty, students and the JNU administration to try and come to a consensus to bring it to an end. But that ended in a bloody battle. That ended with these 50 goons, we are told, including men and women. We are now told they were many of them outsiders, not even students, who came into the campus and can be watched in those very shocking, disturbing videos where you hear the students shriek out for help and you hear these goons saying, "I will come and beat you up regardless." Now, we are standing in the morning, Monday morning, understanding what exactly unfolded. I have with me some eyewitnesses, some students over here, and also some professors, all eyewitnesses into what happened. I also have with me, we spoke earlier with ABVP to understand their side of the story as well. There have been lots of political reactions coming into this, but I'm not going to get into that. Let's talk about facts here. Let's talk about what exactly happened, because that is key at this point. Firstly, just identify yourself. Tell me, where were you at around 6:30 when it all started?
I was there. There was a JNUTA's peace march and the talk was going on. So after it's just over, we were there on the T point and we were assembled because we are so scared of the, because before that they have thrown stones on us. So we are literally scared, and all the teachers and the students were together. So on the meanwhile, we just saw ki all the street lights goes off, and there's some goons, like a huge number of people with masks, carried with the weapons like hammers, rods,
you were saying street lights, not just outside, but even inside, yes. They were all switched off.
Yeah.
So street lights are brought down, and then you see this group of people, this gang, come in and beat up people. Yeah?
Like, yes. It's no, like, I can't even explain the fear I had yesterday. Like, we were just trying to see from everywhere.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
I'll
have it. Thank you. Yeah.
We were just trying to save ourselves anywhere we can hide ourselves. Like in the hostel, they were going inside the hostel, we're going inside the girls' hostel. Like they have vandalized. Yes.
When which I was, hostel were you in?
I was hidden on the Koina hostel upstairs. Like, I don't know whose room it is, but they just said he will come inside. So in niche there like a goons, they started shouting and it was really scary. We are trying to reach every friend of ours, like is it safe or not. But what we what we experienced yesterday, we literally can't imagine in a campus like JNU, where we talk about decent and deviant, and these people come from outside and beat us.
Tell me your experience. Tell me your name first.
I'm Abhimanyu. I'm doing my PhD from Center for Historical Studies. In the whole time I was there in the hostel, my room is just in the extreme corner of the hostel, where I was able to see all the happenings, all the movements of the people, because it's right in the corner. And all the people who were gathering, who were going out, who were going in, I was able to get that. I was with two of my friends. I was there in my room. So when it all started, not yesterday, but it was there in the campus. They were beating people who were on the lockdowns in the centers. They were beating. They were getting. They were fighting with them to just open the gates so that they can do whatever they want. Open the gates of the schools. Open the gates of the schools.
So like we said, for the benefit of our viewers, JNU has been on a shutdown for the past 70 days or so.
Yes.
On the issue of student fee hike. And they wanted to open the gates and get the classes going.
Yes. So let me...
And who is they? When you say they were trying to open, who are these people?
There are 5 to 6 people. I'm not claiming, I'm not saying, but... they are the people, 5 people from ABVP who are everywhere. They are fighting, they are beating common students in the campuses. Last week when there was fight, they beat not just those who are involved in lockdown, but those who found on the bus stop, on the hostel mess.
But how
on
did
the
you
road?
Identify that they're ABVP?
Because they are fighting everywhere.
They had masks on.
Yesterday they have masks on.
Yeah.
But before that they
you
were.
You identify them, you're
yes,
saying?
Yes.
Okay.
So I just want to clear one more thing, which you just said. This is a fight between ABVP and the left party. This is not entirely correct. This is not fight between ABVP and left. This is fight between ABVP goons and the rest of the students, who's involved not only left, but there are more than common students who are involved. And they have on their stake for staying in the campus because of the fee hike. They are not going to stay here. As you can see right now, lots of people are leaving the campus because of the fear.
Yes.
So common students.
I see lots of students actually pack up their bags and go. And since you talk about ABVP, I think it's important to give ABVP a word as well. You heard them. They're not shying away from the fact that there was violence in the campus earlier as well. But now they are saying for the first time that they identified.
Yes.
There were known ABVP faces seen leading this mob.
Yes, yes.
How can you justify this?
They should tell that do he know about the incident happened in Periyar Hostel as well? You know, the residents have been beaten up by all those left goons at noon. And he himself was the person who was beaten up. He himself was a person, they told us that he himself was a person who was identifying the rooms of ABVP boys. I took his name as well. You know.
You talking about him?
Yes, he is.
Okay,
he is.
So the person who has claimed... No, come. Who are saying?
Do you have proof?
Do you have proof?
No, do you have proof? Yes.
You are taking my name. Why?
मैं आपको बता रहा हूँ सुनिए मेरी बात सुनिए मेरी बात मेरी बात
सुनिए मेरी His allegation, one second.
मैं इसलिए बोल रहा
हूँ. His allegation is very clear that there were known ABVP faces who were leading the charge yesterday, last evening. I'm not going to go back into Friday and Saturday because that did not lead into blood.
कल दोपहर की बात है.
That's not going to lead into blood.
कल दोपहर की बात है.
I'm talking about incidents yesterday and please tell us now with ABVP faces being identified, where do you stand on this?
I'm telling you, at the noon when this incident happened, the patrao was going on. The students were coming inside the Periyar hostel. And I was at my floor, I was going bathroom and something has happened at the floor. I just came down and patrao was going on. You know, in that incident, my phone got broken and when I just locked myself inside my room, one more roommate was there. Locked myself inside the room and when at the evening, I just got to know that people were there who were there in hospital. And he was. They told me that he was one of them. And many outsiders was also there in the Periyar hostel who were beating them, identifying that this one is of ABVP, this one is of ABVP.
So what we've done is we've shown you both sides. We've got you very fairly, and I think I've given them equal time. I'm trying to make you understand both sides of what exactly the versions are. It is going to be up to Delhi police to hopefully do an unbiased investigation into all of it and then perhaps come out with who exactly they are. The update at this point is the Delhi police took in complaints, multiple complaints from a lot of people. They filed one case. And that one case has now gone to the crime branch of Delhi police, which will be looking into CCTV camera footage, looking at people, interviewing them, and perhaps coming up with a proper investigation. The shocking part in all of this has been that despite this being such a scene affair, where people are witnesses, no arrests, no detentions have taken place, at least as of 10 o'clock this morning. I have with me some professors here as well. So your first thoughts? We've been listening to both sides of the story over there. There is blame game. Ultimately, it will be about who these goons were. But the culpability, should we not be asking questions to the administration, who is primarily responsible for the safety of students over here? We have not heard from the VC yet. All we got was one statement. You were around when it all happened. Did you see him come out, take charge of the situation? What is he saying?
VC is invisible. He is visible on videos. He sends videos to students, to JNU community, etc. He talks to everyone on Twitter. His administration has one gentleman who tries to run the university through circular Raj. He also sends circulars. He doesn't meet people.
You are saying that he stays in the campus, his house is there, his office is there, and he hasn't stepped out?
No.
40 students injured, including faculty, and he hasn't stepped out? It's shocking.
It's completely shocking. The community is completely traumatized. It doesn't matter to them. Because, and I'm saying it with full confidence in what I'm saying, administration is complicit in this. Otherwise, something like this is impossible to happen anywhere in the world. Without that, it could not have happened. So what do we expect from this administration? Right? This administration must go. Right? If there is any first thought you want from us, that would be our first thought.
All right, and the JNU administration, in fact, the JNU Teachers Association at this point are holding a press conference at 2 p.m. today, and they will be putting out their demands and talking about what happened yesterday there as well. So on the larger question of what's happening to the university, now we have galvanization of student movements all across, from all over the country, even all the way to Oxford. People are saying that what happened at JNU is not on. We've seen the student movement on for quite some time. This is just deja vu of sorts of what happened at Jamia not very long ago. At the moment, what is it that JNU needs immediately, apart from a free and fair investigation in this case?
I would like to tell your viewers that this is not just yesterday's incident. I was present. I saw the ghastly manner in which, obviously, students couldn't do this. These were gundas who were beating up people. They went berserk completely. But I think the issue is not who did it yesterday. The issue is, for the last 3 years, there has been a war let loose upon this university. The vice chancellor was appointed, this new vice chancellor, as a hitman of this regime, which believes this university must be destroyed. They've said it in public. Subramaniam Swami said that close down JNU and fumigate it. These are termites. These are the words used. We are termites. That we train Deshdrohis. So do not look at just this one incident. Unfortunately, the media only looks at violent incidents because violence happened yesterday. What has been happening over the last 3 years is the destruction of this great institution in which we've spent the last 45 years.
Four years now.
Since 2016.
We have very senior cabinet ministers who've come from the campus, who are alumnus. We've heard some very strong comments, to be fair, from the Prime Minister, from the Home Minister. I'm just getting reports now that the Home Minister has asked the LG to intervene. He's asked the LG to come here and talk to the students and talk to the people here, reach out to them.
intervene after the event, after 40 people are in hospital? What was the intervention over the last 70 days? A university in front of your eyes is being destroyed. The administration, as he says, does not speak. It does not, the consultative bodies. The JNU had been run from its inception, not by vice chancellors, by the chairpersons, deans, the academic council, executive council. That's how the university was run. All these institutions have been completely destroyed. They do not function anymore. You have here many other teachers who can vouch for it. The whole mechanism of functioning has been destroyed. They've, as I said, appointed a hitman, and they go around doing exactly what they wish, and they empower them. We have WhatsApp messages where people are saying ki aa jao yahan aa jao, police nahi aayegi, VC hamara hai, VC apne saath hai. So I mean, the collusion
is so talking obvious. About he's talking about are these screenshots of WhatsApp group messages which have now been circulated, and our colleague Anita Sharma has been talking about how they are now also being looked into by Delhi police. So what happened is this, just to quickly brief up on these WhatsApp messages, which really go on to show you the intent with which the violence unfolded in the campus yesterday. In these WhatsApp groups, there are unknown numbers, and in there you see people write down and say, okay, where have you reached? The replies are coming and they say, we are behind Sabarmati Hostel. After that, they talk about how, is the police there yet? The response is, no, not yet, but VC has not allowed them yet. So a lot of these WhatsApp groups are happening. NDTV refrained from showing it earlier because it was unverified. We did not know if this was doctored, if this was photoshopped in some way or the other. But now, with Delhi police saying that they will be looking into them, we are also closely looking into these WhatsApp groups as well. So you heard from both sides, the ABVP and the left. You heard from the professors. I want to give the last word to the student over here who's come in. At this time, since morning, I've been looking at students with their bags packed up and leaving the campus. The atmosphere of fear, is there still inside?
Of course. If you talk about the incident, yesterday police were here at the gate, the same police which entered Jamia campus, AMU campus, without the permission of the vice chancellor and registrar. They can't interfere in the JNU. Why not? I want to ask the question, why does not VC allow this police to enter the campus? The same police enters the Jamia campus, the library, and now they want permission here to intervene when the gundas, 50-60 people, totally masked, covered their face, and just and they are hitting the girls even in the Koina hostel, that is a total female residence, and they entered in, they banged the doors, they broken the doors, and they are beating the students there.
In fact, as we speak, there's a scuffle happening at the gates as well. There are students who are now in middle of a very heated argument with, if I can just have some space over here, in a middle of a very heated argument with the guard over here. So things are heating up here at the campus. We're going to wrap it up for the moment. But for all the live updates, stay tuned to NDTV. We will be bringing you minute-by-minute updates on what's happening here at the campus. For the moment, thanks for watching. This is the YouTube segment. You can log on to ndtv.com for all the details, and also NDTV 24/7 for all the latest. Thanks for watching.